Serio, here to bring you My Hockey Live, the Christy Cirino Christmas Classic, the semifinal game here between Malden Catholic and the Hingham Harbormen in the opening game tonight. Austin Prep prevailed over St. Mary's 3-2. Lou Finicaro Jr. with the winner under 5 minutes to go. And a couple of St. Mary's power plays were not enough to, power play goals weren't enough to beat the Cougars of Arlington, of Austin Prep. And Austin Prep will be in the finals tomorrow night against the winner of this one. And Mike, right now they're going to make some pregame announcements in honor of Christy Cirino, the late coach of Malden Catholic. And it's a great tournament every year here in Malden with these four teams.
Yeah, it's a couple years running this tournament now, and it's always been a great tournament. There's a great field between four teams and potentially even future Super 8 competitors. And we should see a great game here tonight between MC and Hingham.
And now a moment of silence for Christy Cirino.
Thank you very much, Coach Cirino. And now for the ceremony of puck drop.
And now they have the ceremony of face-off. Matt Shula will come out from Malden Catholic. We'll see who will come out for the Harbormen. Could be Captain Billy McNally, number 8. And there we see Billy McNally skating up towards the MC bench across the way. And he'll square off against Matt Shuler, and they'll give the puck to, I believe that's one of the Cirino granddaughters. And nice touch here, and the picture will be taken here as Matt Shuler, one of the tri-captains for the Lancers. And Billy McNally now move into position, take his picture with the members of the Cirino family, and
we would also like
along with Matt Shuler and Christy Cirino, of course, turned things around here at MC a few years back, and his untimely passing as a result of cancer. And Coach John McLean has picked up the baton in Christy's absence here, and carried the program onto equally as good heights. Of course, we talked last week about four straight Super 8 championships. It was shortened last winter by St. John's Prep, who was the victim of the first in that series back in 2011, a tremendous game, an overtime game where Brendan Collier was able to notch the winner in the Garden, and that set the Lancers on their way to four straight Super 8 championships, and of course they lost 2-1 last year to Kyle Martin in goal in the St. John's Prep Eagles, and St. John's carried on their undefeated season today with a win earlier against Pope Francis knee Springfield Cathedral. Right now we'll show you the starting lineups for the Harbormen. Andrew Driscoll will start along with Mark O'Rourke on defense. Billy McNally, the captain, whom we mentioned a couple of minutes ago, will start at center. That's the forward line, rather. Will Jones, one of the captains, will be on defense.
On right wing, number 26, Jack Hennessy.
And Jack Hennessy will play right wing. They introduced that as defense, wing, center, defense, wing. So,
interesting new way to do it. They did it in numerical order.
Yeah, they actually introduced six starters plus the goalie. And Matt Personini, the veteran goaltender, the senior, whom we've seen before, will start between the pipes. And maybe it's an advantage that they get 7-on-6 here as the guest. Kyle Casey will get the nod in goal for the Lancers, the veteran, the junior. Pat Harrington will man one of the point positions for Malden Catholic. And number 44, Matt Yannakopoulos, a familiar pairing early in the season.
And left wing, number 5, Corey Goldstein.
Up front will be Goldstein, Botticelli, and Cam Walter, no doubt.
And at center, number 26, Dick Bertadotti. And right wing, number 13, Cam Walter.
So Coach McLean has kept the same unit intact that we saw last week against Del Barton. And right now we'll have our national anthem. tournament as we look at it this year. The Cereno, in the past couple of years, it's been Molly Catholic's tournament to lose. They've been the predominant favorite in the tournament they host. But this year, maybe a little bit different. They lost some big guns. We talk about Matt Philippe, who many say was the best player in the state last year, now playing the USHL. And certainly the Lancers will miss his scoring ability and his offensive ability up front, his all-around offensive ability, not just scoring. And they lost some other talented guys, too. Will Lawrence was a great defenseman to settle things down. John McClain could score a will from the point. And, you know, guys like the older Goldstein and Jack Adams and, you know, there's a plethora of talent that is no longer here skating for the Lancers.
Yeah, MC certainly lost a lot of talent, and they're going up against the Hingham squad, who really looks to build off their performance from last year. They didn't live up to expectations last year.
Well, they lived up to expectations once they got in the state tournament.
Exactly.
Winning the D1 tournament.
But MC really, this is a new MC, and they're going to have to take a different approach where they don't have that star that they've had the past couple years. And it's really more of an ensemble approach, and they still see themselves as the favorite in this tournament, despite
sure.
the talent on AP, Hingham, and even St. Mary's, who fell by one goal to AP.
MC plays in, of course, the Catholic Conference, which is the toughest league in the state. Hingham, an independent, plays, I believe, every Catholic Conference team in the regular season, and they lost to St. John's Prep 2-0 with an open net goal, and they come in hoping to do good things in this tournament with a good showing here. Quickly underway, a puck in the Hingham end, and MC trying to forecheck to keep it in down low. Botticelli now circles. We'll send it back to Yannakopoulos, but it bounces off the boards all the way back into the MC end, and Harrington has to retreat there and circle the net and send it quickly up to Goldstein. Goldstein can't control, and McNally now can't control for Hingham, and Botticelli jumps on it. Botticelli, right circle. His shot goes wide at Personini, and caroms all the way back out to the blue line where Jack Hennessy able to chip it out to center ice for Hingham, and both teams will look to change now, but interception here by Shula just off the bench. Matt Shula can't get it into the Hingham end, and it's loose at center ice, and now knocked over high by Frankie Higgins. The glove of Higgins stays in play, and play continues. Matthews now will try to go wing to wing up on the right side. Here's Justin Collins in alone, and his backhander is stopped by Personini. Tough angle there, but good job by Collins. Good awareness.
Yeah, it's a good play by Collins. We know, seeing Justin Collins these past year and even into this year, he's always finds a way to be in the right place. He's a real headsy player. And MC, they kept up this fast pace that they started last game against Del Barton with here early.
As you say, Thomas Albert on the right wing over there with Thomas and Tim Matthews. Good skilled hands guys here. And, you know, they're a second line from all the Catholic, but they'd be a first line from many teams. And Hingham has to be aware when they're out there as well.
Yeah, MC likes to roll this line pretty much even with that first line.
Steven Jacobs for Hingham now, able to get it up the boards, but not out. It's sent in, a long shot sent in by Maloney, steered wide, and they battle behind the net. Frankie Higgins for Hingham, and now joined there by Tommy Kornack. And finally, Hingham able to work the breakout this way to Jacobs. Jacobs, the defenseman, lugs it over the blue the red line and will take it in the zone. He'll get a wrister, but blocked by Shula there and jumped on by Collins. Collins able to lug it out of the zone. Third line out there now, Tom Sullivan for Malden Catholic, trying to get it in deep. He battles along the boards right in front of the Hingham bench there, and now it's sent in by Wren, but not all the way in. Some mucking over there, and Wren comes up with a tough angle. Shot saved by Personini. Knocked into the corner. Sullivan now trying to find Wren behind the net. Caroms all the way around to the left wing over here. That's Joey Garino. They play catch at the point. Harrington, Yannakopoulos through a screen goes Yannakopoulos. It's knocked wide, but right on it is Garino. Garino takes a hit in the corner. Able to get it behind the net, but intercepted by the Hingham defense. And now they break it out this way. And that is Andrew Driscoll in the middle. On the go is number 14 for Hingham. That's Jack Grady, but he can't get through the MCD, and they break it out all the way the other way. And with the fresh ice, it scales all the way down the ice before even Marco Rohr can catch up with it, and icing is called here with 12-12 to go in the first period of play. No score, just underway.
Yeah, Hingham did a good job there on that breakout to try to produce some offensive effort. But we see that stout MC defense, the pairing of Harrington and Yannakopoulos, even late in a shift, are able to kind of quell any chances Hingham tried to get.
MC, like many of the teams in the Catholic Conference, loves to run the offense from the defense.
Yeah, especially with the personnel grouping they have. They trust their three defensemen they have coming back more than anybody on their team.
First group out there from Alden Catholic again. Botticelli now can't get it by O'Rourke. Botticelli gets it again behind the net, tries to get it to Walter. Walter now has it as it jumps loose. Walter will try to cycle it around to Botticelli. He's knocked down behind the net by Jones. And now Botticelli gets it again. He's spun again, and a hit there by Goldstein coming across from the other side on Avery Ayara. Rourke will hustle it up from his defensive position. I think there's a fourth group out there for Hingham already. Jack Quilty out there as well, but MC able to clear it deep into the Hingham zone where O'Rourke will clear and try to find Hennessy over here. Hennessy can't find the handle. Nobody can find the handle here, and offsides is whistled.
And we're finally starting to see our first taste of physicality in this game. And if that can keep up, that's an advantage to Hingham. We often see public schools will often try to get chippy with a more superior, in theory, more superiorly talented Catholic team. We see evident by the Will Jones hit on Botticelli behind the net.
Yeah, and I don't know if chippy's the word, but physical, definitely. Here's McNally with a shot save there. First save of the game, I think, for Kyle Casey. Comes all the way back to the Hingham line where Tommy Kornack will play it across for Jacobs, but MC regains control. Harrington in the middle of Mitchell. His shot is blocked by Jacobs. Justin Collins on it, though. Gives it to Harrington, who's still in the offensive play from his defensive position. And they knock it out to center ice. I think Jacobs gloved it out. Comes back to Yannikopoulos. He'll back it off the boards to Albert, caught on his off wing, but Albert now 1-on-3, can't gain control, and it shifts back to Yannikopoulos, who'll play catch with Harrington quickly up to Guarino. Short shifts here, but both coaches trying to get guys out there and get the legs into the game.
Yeah, I think it's just a feel thing, trying to get, I mean, both teams are deep, as we know, so they're both just trying to get everybody involved here early.
This is Gray Betts, a freshman number 10, good size for Hingham, first time we've seen him. He'll chase Maloney into the corner. Betts will send it around to Andrew Driscoll. Puck battle for in the left wing offensive corner of Hingham, and it's picked up by Shula, who gets it over to Maloney, back to Shula. Shula quickly up to Sullivan. Sullivan trying to find Wren, but he can't get by big number 22, Joe Rooney, at center. And it comes over to Will Jones, back to Rooney. Rooney back to Jones, intercepted by Wren. He's in, save Persinini, and the rebound gets poked through Persinini and hit the post and came right back under Persinini. Good job by Sean Wren.
Yeah, MC forwards, we see it from Wren there. We saw it earlier with Collins, really aggressive. They always have one guy very aggressive in the deep. And we mentioned the trust they have in their defensemen. It shows if you're willing to put one forward so deep and try to create a chance, it shows that you trust the other four guys to back him up.
Yeah, great point. Off the faceoff goes to Shula. His shot goes wide and high. And Karam's off the boards on the far side, and Jack Grady can't find the handle for Hingham, and MC keeps the offensive flow going. This is Walter to Botticelli, shot blocked by Mark O'Rourke. O'Rourke can't find the handle on the clear, and Walter picks it up high. Walter, a wrist shot saved by Persinini, and it goes into the netting right next to our friend Bob Varney behind the net back there, and Varney has the puck in his hand. Bob Varney, one of the great sportsmen and hockey fans, and he'll carry the puck over and get it back in play. Want to give a big shout out to Mark O'Rourke is out there, number 6 for Hingham, but Mark Igo doing some recruiting for games down in Florida. We hope to get some road trips, Pat Serio and company, to Florida. Do your job down there, Mark and Brooke. MC with the better of the play for the moment, but Hingham finally able to break out. The Harborman, this is O'Rourke, who likes to rush the puck. O'Rourke into the middle. O'Rourke with a wrister, and it's saved by Casey. I'm not sure he saw that one.
I don't think he saw that one either, but sometimes it's good. Just positioning and able to push works aside.
Here's Hennessy, low angle shot saved by Casey. Good flurry by Hingham. First one, really, of the game.
Yeah, Casey finally got tested. We saw the skill from Mark O'Rourke coming in from his own end to get a shot off, and Casey deflecting with his helmet, but keeping the pressure going from Hingham. That's going to be key early in this game to kind of have Casey feel some rubber.
Higgins on the draw for Hingham, gets it back to the point to Kornack, who dumps it in deep, chasing his gray Betts there, but MC able to break it out. They can't get it by big Will Jones over there on the left point, and now they get it over the line, but offsides is called as Guarino was in, I don't know, 4 or 5 feet before the puck. He had the momentum going. He just wanted the puck there earlier. 8:37 to go, first period of play. No score between Hingham and MC here in the Christy Cirino Winter Classic. Puck dumped in by Andrew Driscoll for Hingham, and he gives chase on Jack Sullivan. Sullivan will get it up to Guarino. Guarino trying to find a breaking Tom Sullivan, but now it goes to Jack Sullivan, who banks it off the boards. Intercepted by Will Jones, who dumps it back in deep. to the right of Casey. Retreating on it there is Shula. Shula over to Sullivan, back to Shula. They're looking for Garino. They can't find the connection. Good forecheck here by Hingham. Now Sean Wren will go back the center and try to help out. He gets it calmly to Jack Sullivan up the wing for Cam Walter just off the bench. Walter will skate it to center. Walter has trouble getting by Austin Cohen. Good play by Cohen, number 11, for Hingham to stop the rush by Walter. And now a hand passes whistled at center ice with 7:48 to go. First period of play, they're going to call this one all the way back into the Hingham end.
Yeah, the faceoff's going to end up back in their own end, so bad result, but a fantastic shift there from the forward pairing. Great bets, Austin Cohen and Avery Ayara did a great job putting pressure on the MC defenseman, making them make a decision real quick, tiring them out and letting them know that they are here to play.
Yeah, quick's the word, I think. They were right on top of things, and that's such a key to win battles and get to the puck first. Hingham's first wave out there. They get it to Hennessy on the right wing. Shot saved by Casey there. McNally on it, left wing corner. McNally's shot goes wide. Karam's off the boards. Hennessy first on it for Hingham, though. And he's trying to find Jeff Gordon. Couldn't connect. And Yannakopoulos skates it out for MC. Quickly to center to Goldstein, but he can't get it into the zone. Intercepted by Gordon. This is Gordon, one on three for the moment. Now he's got support from McNally and O'Rourke. O'Rourke, nifty stick there, but nice play by Goldstein. It kicks over to Gordon, though, and he gets it in deep. Hennessy bumped off the puck, but gets the puck. Good bump by Yannakopoulos, but possession kept by Hingham. Centering pass by O'Rourke, looking for Hennessy in the middle. Doesn't connect, and now Botticelli over the line. The Hingham bench signals offsides, but Botticelli keeps going. Botticelli step in front. Save Personini. What a play by Botticelli.
A great individual effort to win that battle in the corner against Betts and get a shot off, but Personini does a great job standing tall in his cage.
MC dumps and changes wholesale. It allows Hingham to break it out. This is Driscoll. Driscoll down the right wing, trying to go around his counter number three, Maloney. Centering pass, knocked back into the corner. MC able to clear. Quickly out the other way is Thomas Albert. Albert trying to get around the defense. Albert in close. Tough angle shot, save Personini. MC maintains control, and now Betts on it for Hingham. Betts and Matthews battle. And Jacobs comes up with it for... I believe that's not Jacobs, that's Joe Rooney. 22 is half of 44. Shula, nice play at center to intercept the Hingham rush and get it to the Hingham line, but quickly up is Will Jones. Nice move around Matthews. That play is almost offsides, but they let it go. Jones can't get it in the middle into scoring position, and MC able to break it out. This is Albert, Thomas Albert. He's got a guy going to the net. Albert can't get it through the Hingham defense, and the Harbormen come the other way. Nice play at center there by... number 18, Joey Garino for MC. Garino gets it back, trying to find Wren on the breakout, but it comes to the Hingham back check at center ice. That was Marshall Terrace. And now it comes in on Personini, tries to poke it forward. Wren gets it for MC. Wren circles in the left wing corner, back to Yannakopoulos. Quickly over to Harrington. Harrington looking right wing. The shot saved by Personini. Off the stick of either Wren or Sullivan.
Personini, great job to stay with that puck, though, despite all the traffic in front, puck bouncing everywhere. Good job to just get it to no danger.
Yeah, Personini's been the busiest guy in the building. Shots have to be 12-2, I would guess. Now, finally, Marshall Terra is able to get it up to Drew Hickey, but Hickey can't clear, and Wren will tee it up from center ice. Shot is blocked. Yannakopoulos first on it. He'll dump it in deep, but it goes into the net, and that's going to come... that should come all the way back, but I think they're going to call it at center ice here with 4:49 to go, opening period of play. No score, but I have to say Matt Personini, number 35 in net for Hingham, is the number one star of this period so far.
Yeah, and if you're MC, you're going to have to love how that last sequence played out. Kind of helps them out to get this game fast-paced. They don't want a lot of whistles. They want things to keep going, and even they carried the play in the offensive zone a lot too.
McNally trying to find Hennessy, intercepted by Maloney. Quickly into the middle to Goldstein. Takes a little bit of a bump, but MC maintains control until it's cleared now to center. McNally now can't steal in the offensive zone, and it's loose at center. Here's Shula on the jump. Shula over to Botticelli. Botticelli trying to go around O'Rourke. Botticelli still with it. Good, strong stick on it. Nice pass by Goldstein, a shot by Schuler, and a save by Personini. Great play by Corey Goldstein.
Corey Goldstein, great play there to get the puck and to pick his head up and to find his defenseman Schuler kind of creeping down and get a good shot, but Personini playing those angles well and is able to just cover that one up and settle things down for the Harbormen.
Once again, Schuler, the defensive jump into the play. Yep. He's like a fourth forward up there.
Yeah. They were kind of seeing that a lot around Massachusetts, trending toward talented defensemen. We're seeing it with Schuler, we're seeing it with Harrington and Marco Rourke here for Hingham.
Great points, Michael. Here's Albert. Now Matthews, good support. Matthews will backhand it down low into the corner to Albert. Quickly back to Jack Sullivan. Long wrister save. Personini on a tester off the stick of Jack Sullivan.
Sullivan, I think if you're Coach McClain there, you'd kind of want a lot more traffic in front Sullivan's going to take that 40-foot wrister, but he's able to kind of get off the ice, get another legs here. Donna comes on the ice, and they trust Justin Collins to win those offensive draws, so not a bad play.
No, it's a good play, but you're right. If MC has a little more traffic, as we saw yesterday in a game between St. John's and BC High, the two goaltenders were by far the dominant factors
Absolutely.
In that one for 40 or 50 minutes of that game, and you got to get traffic in front. You got to try to get redirections and, you know, anything but a normal shot because these goalies are talented enough they're going to stop those shots.
Yep. Absolutely.
Hingham able to win the draw and break it out. This is Jake Quilty. Quilty sends it long and deep into the right-wing corner where Austin Cohen will chase. And now Matthews off the boards for Collins coming the other way from Walden Catholic. Has trouble getting by LaStoria but gets it back. And now a great back check there by Jacobs. They intercept the centering pass off the stick of Collins. It's loose. Jacobs now first to it for Hingham, and Jacobs will follow it and try to get it up the right wing. But good forecheck there by Justin Collins, and now a hit thrown by Alberts, but they're able to get it over to Quilty on the far side. Quilty now up to Jacobs, the defenseman. They're trying to change, so Jacobs will take it alone, blocked by Harrington. Defenseman on defenseman, and Harrington starts out the other way, but good play by Hennessy to keep it in. This is McNally. McNally can't get it around Wren, and MC's able to clear. This is Thomas Sullivan. Tom Sullivan on the go. Broken up there by number 27, Jeff Gordon, who gets it over to Hennessy. Hennessy, long wrister off the blocker pad of Casey. Hingham able to keep it in the left point. That's O'Rourke, but he can't gain control. And now Will Jones takes a swipe at it, doesn't get full bore on it. And MC able to work the breakout here. But it comes to the stick of Jones, who will dump it in again. 2.5 to go. Opening period of play. No score between the Lancers of Malden Catholic and the Harbormen of Hingham. Cam Walter high off the glass and gunning for the coaches over there, I think.
Hingham now is finally trying to get back into that trend they were in early in the period where they're kind of sustaining pressure and putting pressure on the MC breakout. It all started with Steven Jacobs' individual effort back to kind of block Justin Collins' pass and lead the breakout, and Hingham's had the puck in the offensive zone ever since, and it's been about a minute.
Higgins, Betts, and Driscoll out there, the line now for Higgins, Betts, and Driscoll, the line for Hingham. As Frankie Higgins lost his footing out there near the blue line. MC able to break it out. This is Goldstein trying to work it to Botticelli. Botticelli gloves it down to himself. The net is off here. The whistle should go, but they let play continue. This is Gray Betts. Good back check by Walter here, and the support by number 9 Higgins, and they've got to clear the zone. There was a delayed offside. Now it's waved off, and play continues. Schuler will get it over to Maloney, quickly up to Cam Walter. Hingham knocks it right back in. A little bit of a chess match here where Hingham just wants to get possession and get position on the ice and have some play in the Malden Catholic zone. MC chips it out. It's going to go wide of Personini and go for icing with 1:19 to go in the opening period of play.
Yeah, in the past minute, Hingham's got to be happy with what they've been doing. They kind of got MC on their heels. They haven't really had any chances. I don't even know if they've had any shots, but they've kind of carried possession, and they've been able to get it deep, and they've been able to make MC break out and not get comfortable in the offensive zone.
Terrors on the draw, can't control it for Hingham, and it comes to center. This is Justin Collins trying to sift his way through. Personini comes out, and he gets the job done. It wasn't pretty, but he's able to thwart that bid by the Lancers here. Quickly, MC back in the zone. Nice feed to Collins off the stick of Albert. Collins rather goes the other way, but passes it right onto the stick of Jack Grady, and Grady circles the net and comes out on his off wing. He'll dump it off the boards, but can't get by Harrington. Puck jumps out to center ice to Kornack. Kornack over to McNally just off the bench. He'll come back to Kornack. You don't see that play very often. No. They send it in, and it's stopped by Casey. 32 seconds to go in the first period. Kind of a sloppy couple of seconds here, but here's a break for MC. Tom Sullivan can't get it by O'Rourke. Nice play by Mark O'Rourke to knock it off the stick of Tom Sullivan. Wren battles it, and Wren comes out with it. Wren will take a wrister. It goes wide. Sullivan quickly on it. Back to the point to Shuler. 12 seconds to go now. Shuler over to Harrington. Harrington in the middle for Wren. Wren turns, gets it over the line. Can't get it by O'Rourke. O'Rourke has 5 seconds to do something here. McNally can't find the handle. McNally in the middle, but clock is going to run out here on the first pair of play. I'm not sure McNally knew the clock situation, or he might have thrown it on net.
Yeah, McNally was looking for the perfect shot when he only had 3 seconds to do so. I don't think it was promising either way, but it's a good play for Hingham to kind of get out of that period unscathed. There were times where it looked like Prisonini had to make a couple plays, including the last play there where he looked like Dominic Hasek coming out of his crease. But, you know, MC really, they kind of fell back. They kind of fell on their heels, and they carried the pressure. And it was from that second line, which is a line that just those guys are great in the offensive zone. They're probably the three hardest workers on the team. That is Collins, Albert, and Matthews. And they always got their heads up. They're always looking for each other. And it showed a couple times where Persinini's had to make some good saves to keep him out.
Yeah, MC, they showed, you know, it could be 3 or 4 to nothing if it weren't for Persinini there. But MC, traditionally a late third, you know, a late second period and third period team that they play the full 45 minutes. So, you know, a 0-0 score is not going to bother them. But for Hingham, you're right. They got a feel. Sometimes it's like a prize fight, and they got the feel. They're none the worse for wear on the scoreboard after 15 minutes, and they now know what they're up against, and they know what they can do and can't do. And certainly offensive zone possession is going to be number one on Coach Tony Messina's wish list for the second period.
And you mentioned late in the game how MC likes to kind of bring it later. I think we're going to see that, especially today. Hingham's got to get a goal sooner, because we're going to see Hingham's bench shorten a lot as the game goes along. But MC
is
going to
play four lines at times.
But MC is going to be able to keep those three lines rolling, as we see it a lot of times with public versus private schools, is depth is a big issue. And MC loves to roll their top three lines. They play four defensemen. Hingham, I think we saw everybody get some ice time, but I'll be interested to see how that continues as the game goes on.
We want to thank Nantucket Nectars for their support this year, a season-long sponsor. You'll hear more from them throughout tonight and throughout tomorrow's doubleheader here from the Cereno tournament and from the Framingham tournament, which we're covering as well, the MHL Cup. So Nantucket Nectars, we really appreciate your support. And again, we'll have some messages from Nantucket Nectars. Sullivan Tire has been a loyal sponsor of My Hockey Live. We appreciate their support. The Lufkin Group as well, and more sponsors on the way. And certainly we'd love to have you on board as a sponsor as well. Contact Jane Cornyn at My Hockey Live, and you can find out all about a custom-made sponsorship just for you to reach a great target market, the high school hockey fans and parents and families of Eastern Massachusetts. We're going to take a little break here right now after one from Malden. It is Malden Catholic nothing and Hingham nothing in the Christie Cereno tournament. The winner tonight will face Austin Prep tomorrow night for the championship. For Mike McNamara and Pat Serio, I'm Paul McNamara. We'll take a little break. We'll see you for second period action shortly. Well, second period action underway. Paul McNamara along with Mike McNamara, and following the orders of Pat Serio, who's keeping us here on the World Wide Web. Underway early in period number two of a scoreless tie here between Marlin Catholic in white and Hingham in black. Hingham controlling the play early here as the shot trickles through and goes wide of Casey. And now here's Hennessy, who swings and doesn't get full stick on that one. And Cam Walter on it for MC. Over to Goldstein as they try the left wing breakout. Can't get it by the big stick of Will Jones, who sends a long one in. And that one is gloved by Kyle Casey.
Yeah, great first shift there from Hingham. They got a couple bounces, almost trickled one by Casey. And then a couple quality shots there. And nothing more you can ask for from Hingham after the first period showing. I mean, that's exactly what they needed. They need to get re-energized here and kind of assure themselves that they can play with Melton Catholic.
Yeah, I think it's confidence as well. Driscoll now will come in as being thrown out of the faceoff. Dot is Frankie Higgins for Hingham. Higgins now backhands it in deep, and good forecheck here by Hingham for the moment, but Collins breaks it out on the left wing for MC. Ducks under a check by number 12 Cornack, and they battle in the offensive left wing corner for Marlin Catholic. Matthews able to chip it back to Maloney, who tees up a one-timer off the pad of Personini. Matthews quickly on it, centering pass, looking for Albert, and Collins on the rebound, I think puts it in the net, but the net was off. Now the puck's outside the net, and Collins thought he'd put it behind Personini, but the net comes off its moorings.
It was a good play by Andrew Driscoll in front, kind of to hit Timmy Matthews, and unknowingly or not, knocks the net off right before puck squirms to Collins, and he puts it past Personini, but kind of a lucky bounce there for Hingham.
Yeah, sometimes even when you don't know what you're doing something smart and good.
Well, when you're in the right place like Andrew Driscoll is a lot, it's easy to unknowingly make good plays.
Personini needs a little helmet adjustment there with 13:52 to go, second period of play. Faceoff comes to his left in the MC offensive zone, and they're able to break it out. Now first shift of the day for Matt Dona, big number four for MC. Maybe the biggest kid on the Lancer squad.
He's listed at 6'4". Maybe put him out there, set the tone a little, and give MC some momentum here.
He's paired with the veteran Patrick Harrington. Wren on the draw now with Terrez, I believe, for Hingham, if we can see his number. It is Matthew Terrez, and Marshall Terrez, rather. And that's Terrez trying to bank it off the boards and out, but can't get by Harrington, who keeps it in deep. Wren quickly on it in the right-wing corner, and stolen away now and skated away by number 14, Jack Grady, but good back check by Wren, who takes a stick in the face. Play continues on. The sticks are getting high here all around. And now coming down his off wing is Drew Hickey, who sends a wrister in that Kyle Casey gloves. It was going to go wide, but he'll settle things down.
Yeah, it was a good play by Hingham there to kind of break out, kind of stop the momentum from MC, but a little extracurricular activities in front of Casey as MC didn't appreciate what Jack Grady did to their goalie following the shot there.
And a little extracurricular over in front of the Hingham bench. It looked like the whole town of Hingham was on the ice in front for a moment. Face off in the Hingham offensive zone here as this is Austin Cohen trying to center it in front. Can't move it there into the scoring area, but Hingham battling along their left wing boards, and finally MC able to get it to center. Back onto the stick of Will Jones, quickly up to Kyle Latorney, who sends it in deep, and now good check thrown there by Jake Quilty, but MC able to break it out. Here's Botticelli. He's got Goldstein with him. Two on two. Shot goes off the pads of Will Jones. Shula hustles in to keep it in play. Shula backhands down low onto the stick of Botticelli. Goldstein trying to go through a forest in there. Can't come up with the puck. And now a long wing-to-wing pass. They're trying to spring Jake Quilty on the breakaway. That was Kyle Latorney with a long cross-ice pass. MC able to get it back into the Hingham zone, and here comes Austin Cohen out. Cohen, good job to get it to center and into the MC zone, and they'll head to the bench and change.
It was a good job of Hingham there to kind of stand tall and not let any quality chances from MC despite the pressure they were putting on there.
Shula to Sullivan, over to Matthews. They can't find the handle at center ice, and Botticelli has to go back and help out to Sullivan. And a good check there on Cam Walter by Will Jones.
Yeah, it's not the first big hit we've seen from Will Jones today.
Will Jones, the veteran captain, tri-captain of the Harbormen, number 21, steady defenseman. Hingham now trying to pull the floater play with Jeff Gordon well up out of the zone, and Gordon redirects to Hennessy now. Hennessy one on two, and he takes a hit from Pat Harrington. Goes unceremoniously to the ice. Matthews now back to Collins, quickly over to Albert, can't find the handle, and Jacobs will send it back in deep. Yannakopoulos will swing it back this way towards Albert, but good pinch by Jacobs, but the puck squirts through, and having to give chase way back here is Tommy Kornack. Kornack off the far boards and icing waved off. Play will continue until Casey covers it up in his crease with 11:09 to go. Second period of play, no score.
Yeah, and the Hingham defensemen keep showing us a good job of kind of not letting anything in the middle for MMC, as we saw, whether it be the hitting from Will Jones, the size of Steven Jacobs and Joe Rooney, and then the all-around skill we hear from Marco Rourke. And they're doing a great job kind of keeping everything to the outside and not giving MC anything easy.
Yeah, it seems to be their strategy. They're stepping up well outside their own blue line and try to thwart, like, right there. A good play by O'Rourke to hit Wren, but they don't want to let MC's forwards get, you know, ahead of steam and get going and make plays. You know, it's a little risky, but it's not a bad idea if you can execute it.
And it's worked for the most part so far. We've seen a couple chances from MC develop from kind of over-aggression from Hingham, but most of the time they're able to keep things outside and not let up any easy shots on Personini.
MC with a good forecheck underway here. This is Wren and Sullivan. Wren comes up with it. Wren trying to find Yannakopoulos, but goes right out of the stick of Gray Betts for Hingham. Yannakopoulos regains, gets it up to Wren, but stolen there by number 9, Frankie Higgins. But now MC regains control, and now Hingham regains control. A lot of very short puck possession in this game by any one team, and that's going to be icing by Sean Rennie, was not over the red line and looking for a change. He just backhanded it off the boards, but that's going to go against MC, and they're going to have to withstand a defensive zone faceoff here with 10-11 to go in period number 2.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of short possession because of that aggression we were talking about. All five guys on the ice, both sides, playing aggressive, putting pressure on the puck, and knowing that they're going to need to create turnovers to get something going against each team's really good defense.
On the faceoff now will be Terrors for Hingham against Botticelli for MC. Controlled by the Harbormen. They get it back to Jones. He'll send it through the screen. It goes well wide. Now pinching on the far side is John LaStoria, but he can't keep it in, and Botticelli can't find the handle. And quickly back on it for Hingham is number 14, Grady. They get it over this side to Terrors, who redirects it in deep. Maloney for MC, trying to find Goldstein. Here's Botticelli. It's going to be a two-on-two if they hurry. Shot saved, Personini. And Personini, I mean, that's probably the longest period of time we've gone in this game without Personini having a shot. And that one really didn't catch him asleep, but, you know, you got to be aware when you're not getting shots to be ready. And
yeah, a lot of
he handled that one. Tough angle for Botticelli. But.
Yeah, a lot of times when goalies go a long time without seeing any rubber, they might be sleeping, and a long shot like that might beat him, but Personini's able to stand tall and glove that one.
Austin Cohen, now the center, trying to help out behind the net. They're able to get it over here to number 19, Drew Hickey, but Hickey can't possess, and he sends it in deep, giving chase's Avery Iaria. Iaria's brother Ethan, a graduate last year of Hingham High, who was a really steady player for the Harbormen, really smart, headsy hockey player, and we'll see if Avery can follow suit the senior as well. Here's Collins trying to find an open man, Matthews, but good job by Jacobs to intercept the pass. Harrington now keeps it in at the point. On it is Matthews looking for Collins. Matthews tripped up by Jacobs, but play continues. Yannakopoulos one-timer goes well wide. Caroms off the boards all the way out to Harrington closing on the far side. Harrington in very deep behind the net and now loses it, and Iaria can't control, and Harrington goes over and gives Iaria a bump. Finally, O'Rourke able to chip it up ice to Jake Quilty, but Quilty can't control, but there's O'Rourke into the middle. O'Rourke a shot, saved by Casey. O'Rourke is always on the puck.
Yeah, he's got great hands, and we see it a lot, and it'll create offensive chances for him.
Harrington now fans on it. McNally picks it up for Hingham. McNally into the zone. A lot of bodies in a small area over there, and it kicks wide to That's Joey Garino. Garino in the middle looking for Tom Sullivan. Can't connect. Good back check by Hingham. And McNally starts out the other way at the red line. McNally bounces it off the boards. Sends Hennessy in deep to forecheck. But good job by Shula to circle and pick it up and backhand it up the right wing side. And Tom Sullivan able to break it out for MC. Tom Sullivan one on three. Can't get by number 12, Tommy Kornack. And now sticks get high over there between Sullivan and Hennessy, I believe. And now here's Wren with a shot. Personini never saw that one. Hennessy can't control. McNally back there. This line for Hingham's been out there a while. They're tired. Good job by Wren to get it back to the point and redirected by Cam Walter. The shot off the stick of Matt Dona. Walter now down low to Goldstein. Good offensive zone here for Malden Catholic. They've got a mixed line out there. They've got Walter. Walter, the shot saved Personini. It's Walter and Goldstein, and Wren finally getting off the ice. Walter, a shot and a save by Personini on a nice pass by Corey Goldstein from the corner, and good flurry by those two wings and Wren, who was still out there from the other line.
Yeah, great possession there. We saw Walter, we saw Garino, we saw Wren, we saw Donnie even get in the action. MC kind of working all five guys into it and peppering Personini with shots, and now they'll be rewarded with an offensive zone draw, but they think they should have been rewarded with a goal.
Just past the halfway mark with 7:08 to go in period number two. We are scoreless here in the semifinal round of the Christy Cirino Christmas Classic. Here comes Hingham the other way. Good shot and a save there off the stick of Gray Betts by Kyle Casey. Puck loose in the MCN. O'Rourke will send a wrister through. That almost looked like a knuckleball that is handled by Casey. And now I'm not sure if we're getting a penalty call here or... No, I guess it's just a face-off in the corner and no more changes.
Yeah. Coach McLean changing up his guys very quick to utilize that last change there.
He's going to send the Collins line out there with Yannakopoulos and Harrington on the back line. And now a whistle. Hingham's second wave out there with Higgins, Betts, and Driscoll. And now Higgins waved out of the faceoff dot again. That's the second or third time that's happened. And Driscoll wins it on the forehand to Gray Betts. Betts sends it in the corner. No one there for Hingham. Harrington now trying to leave it for Yannakopoulos. Yannakopoulos quickly up to Thomas Albert. Can't control it. And O'Rourke never hesitates. He sends it back deep, but it goes wide. And MC will possess on the breakout, but they misconnect in their own zone. They have to retreat. Yannakopoulos to Albert. Nice chip over to Collins, but he can't control. And Jacobs will send it in deep for Hingham, and they will change now. Terrence can't catch up to Yannakopoulos, who sends it back to his partner, Harrington. Quickly up to Alberts, leaves it for Collins. Collins checked by Terrence and now bumped by Jacobs. Goes to Jones. Jones winds it around the boards. Interception over there by Matthews. In the middle to Albert. Quick move, but can't get a shot away. And Jacobs able to break it out. He'll send it up the right wing to Hickey. Hickey sends it in deep past Shula. Hickey on the go with Shula. Nice play by Matt Shula. And Collins quickly back to pick it up for MC, but can't. Looks like the puck's tough to handle out there today. It is, 85 degrees here outside? So sometimes that happens. Matthews can't control, and Jones will send a bouncer in that Casey saves but can't control. Shula now backhand to Yannakopoulos to try to calm things down. And, you know, you said Coach McLean likes to switch quickly. This line's been out there a long time by his standards. Matthews can't control. Nobody can find the handle here.
Yeah, they can't. Oh.
And that one, Casey almost lost the handle on that one, but it was well wide. Yeah. MC will ice it gladly and get a change, but all Hingham there.
Thomas Albert there. You saw just how he iced it. Was just frustrated because that was just not a good shift for them at all. The puck seemed to be on edge for about 2 minutes straight and almost trickled by Kyle Casey. And sometimes to beat such a stout goalie, you need it. And we saw a couple long shots that almost beat him.
Yeah, there wasn't one pass that MC controlled flat.
No, and Hingham took advantage.
Sean Wren's line out there now for Malden Catholic. Shula will chip it around looking for Garino. Garino bounces it off the boards. Takes a hit there from Avery Iaria. And I think it went off a hand on the a glove on the Hingham bench. It might have caught more than a glove. It looks like...
I think a wrist, possibly.
A little pain over there. Face-off right at center ice between Cohen and Sean Wren. Austin Cohen's had a pretty good game, number 11. Third line center for Hingham. O'Rourke now.
He's been involved in a lot of the plays.
And the handle as he's trying to find the breakout pass to Jay Quilty, and MC have the control, and now we're going to get the first penalty call of the day. It's going to be an elbow here, I think, on Sean Wren.
Sean Wren's going to go to the box. I think Cohen's helmet popping off kind of gave the official no choice but to call that. And you mentioned Austin Cohen earlier, and it's kind of just his kind of style of player. He's Hingham's version of Justin Collins, maybe. Always involved in everything, always forcing pressure and kind of getting under the skin of the other team, and got under Sean Wren's skin. It's
kind of
a Wren,
like
a Wren the, going to the box for a frustration penalty.
The My Hockey Live not, pepper pot.
Not the first.
Category.
But the first time a Wren.
First power play of the game will go to Hingham here, and we'll see what they can do and try to break this scoreless tie. They've got Jacobs, the left shot on the right point, O'Rourke, the left shot on the left point, Driscoll up front with McNally and Hennessy, and now MC able to ice it. Good play by Harrington. Personini will leave it for O'Rourke, and forechecking is Goldstein. Kind of a selling out forecheck there all in. I mean, Goldstein's a great skater, but got caught deep. Now McNally leaves for Hennessy, but Hennessy challenged right there by Harrington, who gets it up to Goldstein. Goldstein gets his stick high on Jacobs as he heads to the bench. And O'Rourke will bring it up to Hennessy, who leaves it for McNally. McNally circles, slows down. McNally now trying to make the play. Redirect from Hennessy into the far corner to Jacobs, the defenseman. Yannakopoulos knocks down Driscoll in front. And now they get it back to O'Rourke. O'Rourke, I would think they want to quarterback it, but he gives it away. And Botticelli potentially on a breakaway here as Harrington calmly just backhands it in with 30 seconds to go on the power play for Hingham. 3:33 to go, second period. No score between Hingham in black and MC in white. Now Alberts picks the pocket of McNally but can't get it in deep. And Collins, good job of support, but can't get it by the big skates of Jacobs, and Jacobs able to get it up to O'Rourke with 10 seconds to go on the power play. O'Rourke calmly skates it in, trying to find Hennessy, and not a good power play shift for Hingham here as the time's going to come to an end, and out of the box comes Wren. MC able to kill that one with very little effort.
Yeah, just kind of a lackluster power play there. Hingham really couldn't get anything going, and MC almost had the better of the chances there on that power play.
Botticelli misses connection with Albert there. They've got a mixed line out here. Botticelli between Matthews and Albert. And now Hingham can't clear, and finally they do. McNally, these Hingham guys have been out there a while. McNally in the zone, tries a little move to get around Shula, can't do it. And good cover up by Maloney to get it up the boards, but can't get it out. Kept in by Jones, he'll dump it deep left wing corner. Trying to find the handle is Gordon for Hingham, but can't do so, and it's skated out by Botticelli. Botticelli now able to get it into the zone and covering up his Personini as Walter was coming about 500 miles an hour looking for that one, and Jones skated him off. 2:21 to go, second period of play, no score.
Yeah, once again, ever since that power play, kind of Hingham got another offensive possession, but still they just kind of built off that power play where there was really nothing to build off of, and it was they're not getting quality chances in the offensive zone. I don't know if it's still the puck being on edge and not being able to make crisp passes, but MC's doing a good job of not allowing easy shots on their goaltender.
Yannakopoulos dumps it deep left wing corner where they fight for it there. Goldstein and Walter can't come up with it for MC, and Hingham trying to clear. And a giveaway here as it's intercepted. Botticelli, nice backhand pass looking for Walter, but it's poked away on the back check by Frankie Higgins, I believe, and it's going to go for icing. Tough play by Tommy Kornack there. He had an open man, and as he tried to hit him, that lane collapsed, and MC was able to intercept it and create a scoring chance. They never got a shot on net, but dangerous opportunity in a nothing-nothing game.
Yeah, it was a good little two-man play there. Botticelli and Walter kind of a little give and go, but the puck never got found Walter again.
Yeah, Kornack was able to cover Walter and shut off any potential pass. So Wren now on the draw as Terrace is waved out. And taking the draw is number 19, Drew Hickey. Here's a potential two-on-one for MC, but again, they can't find the handle, Guarino, and it's every player on the ice. Here's Wren circling. His shot goes well wide. Somebody lost a stick down there, one of the Hingham defensemen. Yannakopoulos will send it down low. That was O'Rourke who lost his stick. He's got it back now. Sean Wren, who's played a pretty strong game, trying to set something up as he cycles it down for Tom Sullivan. Sullivan is negated there. by, I believe that's Jack Grady in deep. It's Jacobs, rather, 44-14. Now, good play by Wren. Wren trying to get it back to the point, but it's intercepted there by Hickey, who banks it off the glass. Harrington back to get it for MC. Grady can't catch up, and they send it in on net. Casey leaves it for Harrington, and now we get a whistle. It's either a hand pass or too many men. I think it's just an offside.
I believe it is offsides. I think Hingham, with a bad change, kind of changed on opposite sides of the blue line there. And
right. It's the trouble when you got benches that border, they overlap the blue line. It's surprising it doesn't happen more.
Yeah.
Maloney up for Tim Matthews. And Matthews, and now we're going to get a penalty call here on Hingham. And MC's going to go on the power play. And they chuckle that MC called that penalty. But it's going to be Cornack for holding. And it's going to come at 14:08.
Cornack, we saw him doing what kind of the Hingham defensemen have been doing all game. He's trying to hold that line. And he's trying to play aggressive and step up on the MC attackers, but he just made it too easy there. He was too lazy.
In front of the bench, in front of the official.
I mean, if you're going to hold somebody, you got to at least keep your feet moving and make it look like you're...
Yeah, try to sell it.
Yeah, that's an easy call for the official to make there.
So 44-55 on the points. Yannakopoulos and Harrington. They get it up to Botticelli. Botticelli over the line. He's got Albert and Collins with him. A couple of centers up front here. Botticelli banks it off the boards to Yannakopoulos. He'll walk slowly to the middle over to Harrington, far point. Harrington threw a screen, gloved by Personini, very calmly with 25 seconds to go in the period.
It is a different unit than the one we saw success with last week from Alden Catholic against El Barton, with Sullivan, Wren, and Collins up front. Now Collins now with Botticelli and Albert.
Well, also, with only a minute left in the period, maybe the thinking is, you know, try something different. It's only going to be one unit for this part of the power play. Now, Hennessy trying to forecheck. McNally redirects, but under the stick of Botticelli. Look close to being offside, but Botticelli into the middle. Nobody there. Harrington closes. Long shot through. Save Personini. And backhanded out by Hennessy. And the clock will run out on the second period of play, but good chance there for Malden Catholic, really off the second chance, not on the first chance.
Yeah, it was a fantastic thought by Botticelli to pick his head up and have the presence of mind to know that Collins is streaking, but an even better play by O'Rourke and Will Jones to kind of negate that pass and negate that look and help out their goalie a little bit there as in the final seconds of the period.
So at the end of two, we are tied at zero here between Hingham and Malden Catholic. A much better period for Hingham that period. The first period was all MC from our vantage point, and that period was kind of, Hingham really held the play there for parts of that period, but kind of an up and down period, and really, if you're scoring it as a boxing match, it's probably even. And they go to the third period scoreless here, and not sure if it's next goal wins at this point, but in a scoreless game, the first goal is very, very important when it's nothing after two, and the winner gets Austin Prep tomorrow.
Yeah, well, that was kind of a boring period, and second period, when it's a boring period, that benefits the defensive first team, which is Hingham, and they kind of did what they wanted. They slowed down Malden Catholic. They didn't let them enter the zone easily. They didn't let them set up their offense easily. It happened once or twice where MC had a great shift or two, kind of possessing the puck in the offensive zone, but when Personini's had to make saves, he's made them, and but he hasn't had to make a lot of them, and Hingham's kind of slowing things down and kind of lulling everybody to sleep, and it could be potentially dangerous for Malden Catholic.
So we look forward to the third period, the first 38 seconds of which will be a power play for Malden Catholic, and we'll see if they can do anything on that. We are hoping that Coach Lou Finocchiaro from Austin Prep may join us between the second and third period if he's still in the building. He, of course, the Austin Prep coach who won the first game over St. Mary's of Lynn, and if he's still in the building, we'll speak with him about his team and about this season and about this tournament. If not, we'll be back with third period action brought to you by Nantucket Nectars and Sullivan Tires. This is My Hockey Live, along with Mike McNamara and Paul McNamara, and we are here all at the behest and the at the mention of Pat Serio, Serio Video, who is in charge of all our production, does his usual bang-up job here to bring you the best in high school hockey. So we'll take a break right now. If Lou Finocchiaro can join us, we'll be back with Lou. Otherwise, we'll be back with third period action Again, after two, it is Hingham nothing, Malden Catholic nothing. You're watching high school hockey on My Hockey Live. Well, we're underway here for third period action between MC and Hingham. It's scoreless, but now it's not scoreless anymore. 10 seconds into the third period, Thomas Albert has put MC on top, 1-0, with a power play wrister. That's the first one to beat Matt Persinini today, and we have a 1-0 lead for the Lancers.
Thomas Albert, a member of that line for the Lancers that's been producing and been kind of a strong line. And Thomas Albert, just highly talented player. Not only does he work hard, but he might have the best set of hands on the team. And we see there with that nifty roofer. And it's going to take a lot to beat Persinini. And a power play goal down the wing to beat him high glove might be what it takes. And the way the MC defense playing, Hingham's going to have a uphill climb now.
And as you said, Mike, that line, but he's out there with the other two centers, Botticelli and his own center, Collins, there, the power play unit. So Coach McLean has found gold in that one, at least for today.
Yeah, absolutely. And the way the three of them have been playing, Botticelli, we saw at the end of the second with the look for Collins. Botticelli has been a feeding machine tonight, at least. And he's been having his head up all game. He's played well, and he's been finding his teammates. And then Collins, we know the dog that he is. And Albert with a display of skill there to beat Persinini.
That was Mike Bossy-like. You talk about a sniper. That thing would have beaten Tuukka Rask. We'll see if we can catch the assist. Not always the best vantage point to hear the announcements in this building, but no doubt that Thomas Albert authored the Geno.
And a game
and the game clock is now 15:51 to go. And
in a game where we struggled to find a lot of offense, especially that whole entire second period. It only took 9 seconds for Malden Catholic to finally manufacture one. And if you're Hingham, you got to be able to keep your cool here, because whenever you let up an early period goal like that, goal in the period, you run
actually,
the risk of...
This clock malfunction actually helps Hingham, because
yeah.
The momentum,
yeah.
You know, coming out of the locker room with the man advantage for MC, they took very little time to get the job done there, and all they got to get up there is 14:51, not 15:51.
Especially with what we said earlier.
They have to run a minute off. That's
especially
all.
With what we said earlier, how MC really, really plays better in the third than every other period, where you let up an early goal like this and you run the risk of MC kind of finally finding their legs and saying, okay, we're Malden Catholic. We can do this, and dangerous to let up like a four-goal period and lose 4-0. But kind of the next two or three shifts for Hingham are huge to create offense and get some shots on Casey, and you said it true. This clock malfunction can do nothing but help the Harbormen in terms of momentum. And we finally got them to be able to reset the clock there as we wound it down from 1 second, but 13 minutes was posted.
Yeah.
So,
maybe they think there's a Valley League game, and they're going to put 12 minutes up there. So the boys will skate around here and loosen up. It gives us a chance to let you know that Catholic Memorial won the semifinal matchup against St. John's of Shrewsbury in the My Hockey Live Cup tournament out in Framingham. I think it was a 6-3 final or... 7-3 final. Pat Serio chasing down the scores around the state for us. Up at the Pete Frates Winter Classic, St. John's Prep captured that title with a 2-1 win over Pope Francis Springfield Cathedral. And in the consolation game was all BC High. They win that one 8-2 over Central Catholic. And right here, it's a whole brand new ball game now with MC leading at 1-0. And right off the faceoff, Hingham on the attack here. Botticelli now will pick it off the back of the net and try to get it up to Walter, but intercepted over there by Frankie Higgins. Comes to Harrington. Harrington trying to find Goldstein up the wing. Picked by Jones. Will Jones down low. Redirected in front by Higgins. And I'm sorry, by Driscoll, number three. And good save there by Kyle Casey.
Yeah, but save by Casey to keep them up at 1-0. But a fantastic shift there from Hingham. It's exactly how they needed to respond. Yep. And we got two shots off on Casey. And Will Jones looked like he could have taken two or three more steps there and got a better shot off on Casey. But either way, he got the job done, and they were able to change lines here with 14-21 left to play.
Here's LaStoria through a screen blocked by Schuler in front. And Wren can't come up with it. And coming up with it is Grady for Hingham. Grady, now, not a great idea to pass it back to the point as it goes right on the stick of Tom Sullivan. Sullivan will dump it in deep. Persinini stripped over there, and a centering pass by Garino. Good play by Garino, but Persinini got away with one. And now Garino all the way back to pick it up on the back check. Joe Garino with a great shift going. He sends Sean Wren away 1-on-2. Wren trying to get around Big Jacobs over there on the far side. Steve Jacobs, nice job. And number 14, Jack Grady, helping out for Hingham. Good forecheck by MC as they're able to get it back towards the point to Maloney. Maloney finally gets it, sends it back to Wren, back to Maloney. He can't find the handle. There's a delayed offside here, but Hingham will control it and clear it as MC clears the zone. Drew Hickey can't control for Hingham at center ice, and MC gets it to the Hingham line, but not in deep. It's chipped over off the far side, off the far boards, where Shula will pick it up and turn and fire it up for Matthews. Matthews redirects to Wren. Wren has to get it in and change, and now he does. Persinini will leave it behind for Kornack. Kornack up the left side for number 18, Quilty. Quilty can't get it out. Now they finally do muscle it out. But Justin Collins back to get it for MC, trying to find Matthews. Matthews did a 360 here. Not sure if he thought the play was going to go somewhere else. Collins, good job to keep it in. And he's hit by O'Rourke. But Matthews comes out of the centering pass to Albert. Off his stick, back to Harrington. Can't find the handle. Delayed call now on Hingham. I think it's going to be a slash on O'Rourke behind the net there.
Yeah, he broke Collins' stick. And we saw Collins' frustration as he went back to the bench. But if you're going to hack someone so hard to slash their stick, that's going to be a penalty most of the time. And it is O'Rourke.
O'Rourke with an NHL slash there. And it's going to give MC a chance to double their lead here on the power play. They're 1-for-1 today. Off the faceoff, Wren able to get a weak backhander in that Persinini covers up. Sorry, they're 1-for-2 today. No, 1-for-1. 1-for-1. Wren now will try to kick it back. He does to Maloney. Maloney half fans on the shot, and Hingham able to clear. Hennessy will forecheck on the man down. Shula will play cat and mouse behind the net and start out up center ice over to Wren. Wren can't find Maloney, and it's chipped in by McNally right on net. Casey has to make the save, and Hennessy, good job of forechecking. Now McNally with a misthought on the six iron there, and it goes dead over the head of Casey and up into the net directly. Yeah, the faceoff will come outside the MC zone with 1:02 left on the MC power play.
McNally and Hennessy did a good job of not just sitting back and waiting for MC to take the play to them. They showed a good forecheck and kind of to not let this MC power play get anything going forward.
Higgins with a good draw, and they're able to clear it in deep as Jones sends it behind the net. Now MC breaks it out. Collins on the far side to Albert. He has the only goal of the game, Thomas Albert. Albert will swing it back to Yannakopoulos, over this way to Harrington, back to Yannakopoulos in the middle, and Yannakopoulos looks. Down on the left corner to Botticelli. Backhand pass out to Harrington. Quickly over to Yannakopoulos in the corner to Collins. In front to Albert. Albert trying to find a cutting Botticelli. Misses connecting into the corner, but Botticelli able to get it back to Harrington. Quickly to Botticelli down low. In the middle to Albert. His shot is deflected by number 9, Frankie Higgins. Good job. Good thing he got a stick on that one.
Yeah, we see two different MC power play units with kind of two different, completely different identities. This one is showing a lot of talent and puck movement, whereas the other one... We didn't really see much of in the offensive zone, but when they do, they kind of just get the puck on net, and Tom Sullivan kind of turns into Thomas Holmstrom. Tries to
Harrington now
make things happen in front.
Over to Yannakopoulos. Yannakopoulos will go behind the net to Collins. Collins will counter and try to go to Alberts. This, they're keeping the puck outside the zone, outside the scoring zone here. And Will Jones, headsy player, able to send it the length of the ice. Actually, on net, Casey forced to make a save. And penalty time just expiring now. And Hingham back to full strength here with 11 minutes to go in the third period. Yiannakopoulos rushes it in deep and gets a wrister, a good wrister in on Personini. And sticks get high outside of Personini's private area there. And no further harm, no further damage. Whistle goes and wholesale changes by both sides.
Yeah, Yiannakopoulos, a good thought there as he carried into the zone. He saw his forwards coming in crashing and kind of threw it on net. And Sullivan and Collins did what they did best and kind of got some Hingham defensemen mad. And it was a good all-around play.
Now Hingham on the rush here. 2-on-1 if they hurry. They get it in the middle, trying to find Driscoll on the return pass from Gray Betts, but misconnects, and MC able to bring it out. Sean Wren now on the go, trying to get around O'Rourke. Wren up with it again. Shot saved by Personini. Oh, that one went wide, I guess. I kind of lost vision of it, and O'Rourke takes a swipe at it, but Garino able to get it in deep. Wren now behind the net, strong on the puck, and now he finally loses it as he's double-teamed, and they're able to get it over to Gray Betts, who falls down and knocks the door open, and the whistle goes, and looked like Betts hit a rut in the ice.
Yeah, but we saw Wren there with a shot that kind of in a golden spot, and it went just wide. That's the third time it's happened tonight where he's gotten Personini down, and he's been in a scoring area, and he's tried to roof it, and it's looked like the puck's had eyes for the back of the net, and it sailed just wide on him.
They finally announced the official on the goal. It's Albert from the defense pairing of Yiannakopoulos and Harrington, the two power play guys on the defensive unit. So that's the way Coach McClain likes to see it read, a forward from the two defensemen. Botticelli now all the way in. Albert is hammered down in front. O'Rourke is getting his stick up too high, and sooner or later they're going to call that. They already called it for a slash.
Yeah, O'Rourke, we're talking about all the skill he has and brings from the blue line, but with that skill comes kind of a chippy side, and he's got one penalty now and could have been called for interference on that hit. And
Yiannakopoulos back to Harrington. The one-timer blocked up high by Jack Grady. Harrington has to chase it back. He spins away from Grady. Harrington looking. Harrington with some room now. Carries it over the red line and twirls it around the glass. Botticelli fights behind the net. Terrez, he comes up with it. Botticelli looking for Walter. It's deflected back to Yiannakopoulos, to Botticelli all alone. Cross point to an open Harrington. Tees up a slap shot. Blocked in front. Kicked out to Terrez. Terrez will turn and get it in deep and go to the bench. Good job by Marshall Terrez there. He didn't have great position, but he was able to get control and get it in deep. But MC right back out with 9:17 to go. Good wrister there by Botticelli. And a save by Personini. Botticelli lays it back to Shula. Through a screen. Goldstein all alone in front. And it goes in off Goldstein's skate. And they're going to wave it off.
And also the net dislodged there. I'm not really sure how it dislodged. But the combining with the kicking and the dislodging. And Goldstein's goal is going to be waved off.
I'm not sure Goldstein even knew the puck was there. So it was kind of inadvertent. Yeah. But
set up by a great individual effort, though, by Nick Botticelli there coming
well,
in with the win.
Well, a coincidental mine is going to be called on McNally and on Walter. So at 5:53. Didn't see where they were tangling. Teams will skate six aside, five aside in front of their goaltenders, but McNally and Walter will take a rest in the sin bin here. Comes back to Shula, who knocks it in deep. On it quickly is Albert. Albert manhandled over there by John LaStoria. MC, good job of forechecking here. A lot of mucking going on in those backboards. Hingham finally able to come up with it, but can't clear the zone. Nice play by Matthews. And it comes to Collins. Collins has to bring it up. Collins brings it outside the zone, kicks it back to Brendan Maloney. Cross ice to Shula, back to Maloney. To Shula. Shula avoids the forecheck of Driscoll and gets it up to Matthews over the red line, who dumps and changes. Personini will leave it there for O'Rourke. O'Rourke's pass goes off the boards. Icing waved off here. Play will continue. Forecheck by Gray Betts, but MC able to double-team Betts' forecheck and get it out to center. Cornack now up to Drew Hickey. Hickey can't get by Shula. Shula over the line. Three MC Lancers. Pass misconnects in the middle. Shula fights with Jacobs. A couple of big bodies in the corner there. They're joined by Wren and Terrace. Terrace able to come up with it for the Harbormen. Terrace now with some skating room. And smartly skates it out over his own blue line. Trying to find Hickey up here. He misconnects on that one, and it caroms all the way back to Maloney for MC. 7:40 to go in the third period. Malden Catholic on top, 1-0. A power play goal by Thomas Albert. Goal of the game. And Sean Wren just took himself offside there.
Yeah, Sean Wren chose kind of a bad spot to do that spin move there. As we saw Hingham Harbormen defenseman number 44, Steven Jacobs, kind of sticking to the game plan, trying to hold that line and making Wren make a decision at the blue line. And we'll take the offsets.
Starting units out there for each side here on the forward line. Botticelli to take the draw with McNally, who's out of the penalty box now. The coincidental minors are over, and that one was coming right for our million-dollar broadcast booth here, but the netting kept that one out of stereo videography territory. Botticelli and McNally once again. Botticelli will draw it back for Harrington, who retreats in his own zone. He'll send it up the far wing, intended for Walter, off his stick in deep. Goldstein gives chase. Does a good job to neutralize Will Jones. MC with that tenacious forecheck here. They get it in front, but the only guy there is Will Jones for Hingham. Up to Hennessy, who takes a hit from Walter. Now McNally will give chase in the MC zone with Harrington. Nice leverage job by Harrington there, who gets it off the boards up to Botticelli, who gets around Will Jones. It's a three-on-one all of a sudden for MC. Botticelli in deep. Nice play by Jacobs to intercept that pass across. And Yannakopoulos sends it in deep. Centering pass for Walter misconnects, and it comes onto the stick of Grady. Here's Grady on the go, or rather Betts on the go. Gray Betts in deep. Wrist shot saved by Kyle Casey on a tough angle. Botticelli lugs it up the far side, can't get it out. And now they do get it out as Goldstein wrists it. Deflected by a Hingham defender mid-ice. Hingham with a chance and a shot from a tough angle over here by Gray Betts on his off wing goes wide. O'Rourke able to stop it at center ice. They get it in the zone. It's Betts again. Top of the circle. Shot saved by Casey. Gloves it smartly.
Gray Betts, only a freshman, but we see two great plays by him there to create some chances for Hingham. As he gets one shot and makes Casey glove it. But set up, the odd man rush MC had fantastic play by Steven Jacobs, as you mentioned. Hingham defensemen, not only have they done a good job keeping everything to the outside, but getting in the passing lanes when the rare odd man rushes have occurred have been key, have been essential for them to kind of stretch out the play and not let anything easy on Personini.
Yeah, the one mistake MC might have made on that 3-on-1 is they all stayed kind of the same depth. And not an easy play for Jacobs, but it made it easier for him to intercept that. Here's Albert the other way, trying to get around O'Rourke. Centering pass knocked away by Cornack. And a good back check by Terrez, who quickly gets it up to Hickey. Hickey over the line and dumps it, takes a hit from Matthews. Terrez will give chase. He'll take a hit from Maloney in the corner. And MC able to get possession and can't clear off the skates of Albert. O'Rourke intercepts, and Albert runs into O'Rourke over in front of the penalty box area. Now Shula quickly over to Maloney, up to Matthews. Matthews looks for Collins, but misconnects. Matthews has it again. He's challenged on the back check by Jack Grady. And here comes O'Rourke. He takes a big hit from Tom Sullivan, a football player. That's going to hurt.
A Catholic Conference All-Star.
That's right. Sullivan, a great athlete. Now Garino doing a good job and gets it to Sullivan behind the net. Garino taking some hits for his efforts. Now Sean Wren trying to dance around. Wren, a wrister goes high and wide off the glass.
A deadly wrister.
Jack Grady now in the middle up to McNally. McNally back on the ice, 1-on-3. Can't get around Shula. And Wren back checks, and now Shula dumps down McNally away from the puck. Nice interception over there by Gordon. Gets to McNally. He'll turn and fire. Can't get it through the trees down there. Jacobs now quickly over to Will Jones. He'll lift it in and it'll bounce off the backboards. Hennessy trying to forecheck on Harrington. Shula quickly back on it for MC. We're down to 4:25 to go in the third period of a one-goal hockey game. Only one goal in the game. Thomas Albert with the power play strike for MC. They lead it 1-0. Here's Harrington on the go all the way through center. Harrington over the line, left side, trying to get around Jones. Jones takes him to the backboards. Puck loose and Jones backhands it off the far boards, but Botticelli's the only guy there, and he's for MC. Botticelli down low to Goldstein. Goldstein circles, will try to cycle for Walter. Walter able to get it to Botticelli. He's negated there by Jones. And now stolen there by Goldstein. Goldstein to Botticelli in tight. Shot and a goal! Corey Goldstein from Nick Botticelli!
And another play where Botticelli picks his head up and finds somebody open. I mentioned it earlier, and it's true. Botticelli does a great job in the offensive zone in finding people. But let's not forget how MC started that offensive possession. A great play from Pat Harrington doing what he does best, lugging the puck into the offensive zone, even below the red line, before changing and making way for Matt Schuler to come on the ice. But he set up that whole sequence for Mullen Catholic and allows Botticelli to find Corey Goldstein in front.
Just an act. Yeah, good point on Harrington's effort there, but unbelievable, great foot movement, yep. Foot movement by this trio, yeah, of Goldstein, Walter, and Botticelli.
Yeah, you can't forget what Goldstein's doing out front there to make himself open. If Goldstein's just standing still there trying to win possession on his stick, he's not gonna get that puck, and Botticelli will be floating without a paddle behind the net. But Goldstein does a great job kind of moving his feet and tiring out these Hingham defensemen out front, and he's able to get open, and there's nothing Persinini can do to stop it.
Well, they almost had one maybe 5 or 6 seconds before in the near post, and Persinini, yes, did a good job, both of them hacking away at it. Mm-hmm. And then when it got loose behind Botticelli, a smart move, and as you said, great heads up by Corey Goldstein to play without the puck, mm-hmm, move without the puck and get open and give a target for Botticelli, and that happened, bang, bang.
Yeah, it's far too often we see guys just standing in front of the goalie when they have teammates looking for help, and Goldstein does a great job working his tail off in front of the net to give Botticelli an option.
So 3.5 to go, and the mountain just got a little bit taller for Hingham to climb as they trail it by 2 now. And really haven't had a lot of offensive flurry in the last 5 or 10 minutes, really, to suggest that they may get 2 goals very quickly, but we'll see. Harrington now keeps it in at the line for MC. Threw a screen, tipped in front and covered by Persinini. Matthews and Collins right on the doorstep.
Yeah, Matthews thought he had a gift there with that shot making its way through Hingham defenseman, but Persinini does a good job of keeping his pads together and not allowing Matthews that easy goal.
Goldstein, the goal scorer from Botticelli and Walter, that's the official, at 11:13 of the third period. 2 third period goals for MC today to break open a scoreless tie. And they're still at it, kept in by Yannakopoulos. Off the boards, deep into the left wing corner. Albert wide open there. He loses to Jacobs. Jacobs gives it right back. Walter now back to Harrington, quickly over to Yannakopoulos. Good look, threw a screen up high, and Matthews and Will Jones, Tim Matthews and Will Jones going after each other in front of the net as Will Jones did a good job to move Matthews out of there and let Persinini see that one all the way, but gave him a little extra high Hawaii after the play. But
that was far too easy for Harrington to find Yannakopoulos there point to point. When the puck came up to Harrington, I looked straight at Yannakopoulos because that's what they're doing to the puck. Hingham, especially when you need 2 goals late.
The defenseman plays so well.
Especially when you need 2 goals late, you got to pressure the points and try to force a turnover there. You can't let something like that happen so easy. I know you don't want to allow any more goals, but at a certain point, you got to start playing a little more aggressive.
McNally and Collins, the opposing centers, are going to sit for matching minors here at 12:14. The teams will play full strength. We'll see what the announcement is, unsportsmanlike or roughing or whatever, but those two will not be available to their teams right now. For the next minute and a half, this one hits the ceiling on the clearing attempt by, I think it was Jacobs, trying to flip it out, and it deflected off the ceiling. Faceoff will come to the right of Persinini. In the hang of man, 2:35 to go in the third period. MC with a 2-0 lead. The Nantucket Nectars, all natural, bringing you today's action along with Sullivan Tire. We thank Nantucket Nectars and Sullivan Tire for their support of My Hockey Live and the Christy Cirino Christmas Classic here. MC with a jump in their step right now, Mike. They can sense just finishing this one off.
Yeah.
Get one of the Hingham coaches over there. Get off the ice so we don't have too many men. But MC in control right now. Schuler in deep, wrestling over there with Jacobs. And now we get a whistle here. And it's they separate, and there's another whistle from center ice. We're down to 1:57 to go in the third period.
I know it's no harm, no foul, and I know it's Malden Catholic identity for the defenseman to kind of jump up to the play and get low, but dangerous play from Shula with one, and I know he's a great skater, yeah. But with 2 minutes left to play and you're nursing a two-goal lead, I just think potentially might be a better play to dump it in, but...
Yeah, make them earn anything they're going to get.
But sometimes MC believes the best defense is the best offense, and getting their defenseman involved, kind of cycling the puck, is what they do best.
Yeah, they don't change their stripes, I guess, is the... analysis. And now it comes around to O'Rourke off the stick of Lestori. O'Rourke trying to find help up the middle, but the only guy there is Goldstein for MC, and he'll dump it in deep. Like you said, Mike, being smart there, get it in, and they've got one forechecker in deep. They've got a guy high, and that's smart with a two-goal lead, but it comes out to Driscoll here, but he's one on three. Driscoll, stick handles in the middle, leaves it back for O'Rourke, who steps into a slap shot. It goes wide. You know, they're only a goal away from potentially pulling their goalie, so they get a bounce here, and it's a brand-new hockey game here. Mm-hmm. Shot goes wide. Now it's curled around the zone, but Lestoria sends it in. It goes off the stick of a deflection by Frankie Higgins, and now MC's going to ice the puck here. Walter just trying to get it by O'Rourke. O'Rourke, for a skilled guy, does play a physical game.
Yeah, you mentioned one bounce away from pulling their goalie. I was surprised that offensive possession to see Persinini just standing still in his crease all the way in his net. I was surprised they didn't pull him at some point in that possession, but it looks like they are pulling him here for this faceoff.
See Tony Messina.
Hingham,
a wily coach of the Hingham Harbormen, motions Persinini over. He's played a heck of a game. I mean, he trails it 2-0, but he's been one of the stars of the game. And now MC with a chance to go up by a field goal if they can find the open net here. Jacob circles in his own net. We're down to 42 seconds to go. Hingham needs one fast. Terrors now down the left side. They've got an extra man. Sends in the middle, trying to find the deflection from Hennessy. Comes back to Jones at the point. Redirected by Hennessy in front. Nobody there except MC. They clear it but not out. Sean Wren on it now. He'll flip it off. I thought it was going to go off the glass, but it goes off Jacob's hand, and a shot goes off the post for MC. Icing called, but Jacobs looked acrobatic over there keeping it in, but as he turned and threw it forward, it went right onto an MC stick, and they had a chance at the open net from behind their own blue line.
I think Jacobs even surprised himself that he caught that one and just didn't really know what to do, and almost a costly turnover. But
you know, it's easy from up here, but if it's going in the bench area, let it go. Mm-hmm. The whistle's going to go. But that's like interception on fourth down deep in your own end if you got the awareness to just knock it to the ground, you know. 19.8 to go, and Hingham will use its timeout here and try to find the two-goal play here in 19 seconds, and that's a tough one here. MC has earned this one, earned the lead to this point, 2-0. Hingham's played a strong game the way they've had to play it, but they've got nothing to show for it offensively on the scoreboard, and that's a tough situation with under 20 seconds to go.
Yeah, Malden Catholic's played great tonight, and it looks like this team's kind of developing into a team that may turn some heads and surprise people. A lot of people kind of counting them out already because of the lost talent. They lost their whole first line. They lost Jack Adams. They lost McLean. But this is kind of, they're taking on a new identity, and they're playing hungry. They're playing with a passion and a desire that we really haven't seen since the Super 8 a couple years ago when they came in as the 10 seed. And it's kind of a, they've never had to prove anybody wrong. They've always been number one. They've always been top dog. But now is it more of an ensemble, more of a, they got two really hardworking lines, and I think they need to keep that identity to be successful this year.
We failed to mention Jake Witkowski earlier. I mean, whenever you try to mention guys from last year, you always come up and forget somebody. MC's going to call it. They're going to counter and call their timeout now as well. But, you know, Philippe, Witkowski, Austin Goldstein, Jack Adams, as you said.
And Brendan White was quality minutes.
Left school and, transferred. And,
yeah.
And then, you know, you got guys like Will Lawrence back there, John McLean. And
Lawrence. I forgot to mention Lawrence.
You know, even guys like, you know, I mentioned Jeff DeMichelis before. Mm-hmm. He's a fourth liner here last year. But, man, he was out there in some key situations and banging people. And
it's hard to replace leadership.
Exactly. And, you know, that was a great class of juniors / seniors who moved on. They're just sort of reloading, it seems like, though. You know, the core on the defense is back, even though you get Lawrence and McLean out, but these guys saw a lot of action last year because John McLean missed a lot of time from an injury.
But through two games, there's certainly a chip on their shoulder that has been absent as of late.
Yep. Good save by Casey there on the they won the Hingham won the faceoff and got it to Will Jones.
Stupid.
The right shot playing left point, and now they're gonna have a 6-on-4 as Pat Harrington's gonna take a slashing penalty here at 14:48.
Yeah, Pat Harrington thinks McNally did a little bit to sell his little shove after the whistle, but neither McLean nor the officials wanna hear what Harrington's complaints are.
McNally now will take the draw with Botticelli to the right of Casey. 11:10 seconds now. Yannakopoulos hammers it, comes onto the stick of Jones. He'll go to the middle and send a wrister through. And well, from here, it looked like it was in. Puck is still loose. Casey has lost his footing. Now he's up on it again, and a hit at the buzzer there. And that's a bad hit at the buzzer. And one of the MC players is down. We can't see who it is.
I believe it's Matt Shula.
It's either 24 or 26. I think it is Shula.
Shula, he's only out there because Harrington's in the box. And McNally with a...
And I don't think it was Gordon. I think it was a right shot for Hingham. I'm not sure.
Was it 27?
They're sending Gordon out.
Gordon with a cheap shot. Maybe a little frustration that puck somehow didn't go in. But they did not want handshakes.
Yeah, I don't agree with that. But
that certain ref who has been boisterous all game, kicking guys out of the draw from the neutral zone. And
I don't agree with sending the whole team off. I agree with sending that guy off, but they identified who hit him. But it is Matt Schuler, and he's up slow. He's on his knees, and that's a good sign. But, you know, hopefully he didn't hit his head, and hopefully it wasn't a limb that gets twisted and that he's just shaken up for momentarily, and then he'll be back tomorrow for the championship game because Malden Catholic will play Austin Prep in the final of the Cereno Christmas Classic. Tough way to end this as Hingham almost scored with under 10 seconds to go there. Jones stepped to the middle and took a shot through 30 or 40 bodies in front there of a screen. And Kyle Casey earned that shutout, especially in the last 10 seconds.
Yeah, but you got to think, if Shula's a little dinged up, then it has to be somewhat of a Pyrrhic victory with the important role that Shula plays. Kind of, he's, like we said, it's hard to replace leadership, and he's
not
taking the ceremonial draw. He's a great guy. Yep. Everyone in the locker room loves him, and just what he does offensively and defensively. He's all over the ice at all times. He's kind of, he's able to give the first pairing of Harrington and Yannakopoulos a rest, and he's playing with Maloney and Sullivan. He does a great job in all three zones, so... he'd be certainly hard to replace even if it's just the championship tomorrow that he misses. He's a very key player in their
room. Great points. So we can quickly review the scoring. It was nothing coming into the third period. MC started the period with a power play. They didn't take long to connect. Thomas Albert with assist going to Yannakopoulos, and Harrington made it 1-0 for MC just 9 seconds into this third period. And it turns out that would be the only one MC would need. They got an insurance goal later in the period, at the 11:13 mark, Corey Goldstein knocked it home with a nice setup from Nick Botticelli, and Cam Walter also picking up a helper on that one. So two goals for MC were plenty tonight, the way Kyle Casey played, and kudos to Matt Personini as well between the pipes for Hingham. He withstood the barrage for much of the night and was equal to all but two and played a very good game for Hingham in goal.
Yeah, he kept him in a lot of the game, as well as Hingham's defensemen played, keeping MC to the outside and kind of not letting them enter the zone easily. They did, obviously, it's Malden Catholic. They're going to get their chances. And they got their chances, and Personini did a great job. He was really standing tall in between his net, and if it weren't for a snipe from Thomas Albert, for lack of a better term, and great, just a great two-man play from Botticelli and Goldstein, in which Personini just took a rascal to stop the puck. It's a 0-0 game other than those two plays. So, yep. Personini did a great job for Hingham.
So, congrats to the hometown Lancers here. They will play in the final of the Christy Cereno Christmas Classic tomorrow at 5 o'clock, we believe. The final is at 5 o'clock. And in the consolation, it will be Hingham against St. Mary's. I think that one's at 2:15 or so. Check our times tomorrow on My Hockey Live. But we'll have both of those games live for you here at MyHockeyLive.com. We'll also have the finals, the consolation of the finals of the Framingham, the tournament in Framingham, the My Hockey Live Cup, the first of what we hope will be an annual out there. And that'll be CM against the winner of Marshfield and Framingham, which is being played right now. So we thank you for being with us from Malden. For Pat Serio, who always does a tremendous bang-up job in Serio Video at seriovideo.com. We thank Pat for everything today. We thank the folks at Nantucket Nectars, our season-long sponsor, and we'll be talking a lot about Nantucket Nectars throughout the season and more about them tomorrow, and for Sullivan Tire as well. We thank them for their support. For Mike McNamara, I'm Paul McNamara, saying goodnight from Malden with the final, Malden Catholic 2, Hingham nothing. We'll see you tomorrow on My Hockey Live.